Hello guys, welcome back to Chanda DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a very cozy top. It is really easy and friendly for beginners. For this top, it can fit for size small and size medium because we have the back tie to adjust the size. But in this tutorial, I also showing you how to make it bigger and how to measuring it on your body. Okay, now let's get into the video. This is the bust part of the top, and we are going to start working from the back part of the top. For this back part and the bust part, we are working on the length way. So for the number of the foundation chains, it's the height of the top. To begin, make a slip knot. Then chain 28, it is equal 5 inches length. It's measuring from the under bust until my chest. For you guys that make bigger size, please add more chains until you got your measurement. After you got 28 chains, and this is how I'm measuring it on my bust. And after you got your desired length, then continue add 3 more chains. In total, you must have 31 chains. And next, we are going to make the bow crochet. For row 1, skip 3 chains and make the bow crochet into the 4th chain. To make the bow crochet, yarn over. Insert a hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. For this chain 3 that we skipped, we also count as a stitch. And next, continue make the bow crochet into every chain until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, and this is what the first row looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 3. For chain 3, we also count as a stitch. Then turn your work, skip 1 stitch that near chain 3, and make the bow crochet into the next stitch. So start from the second row, reworking the stitch into the back loop only. Keep making the bow crochet back loop only into every stitch until you reach the chain stitch, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the chain stitch, then make the bow crochet into this chain 3 stitch. And this is what the second row looks like. And for the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 13. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 13. For the length of these 13 rows, it is equal 5.5 inches length. And this is how I'm measuring it on my body. You have to measuring this piece, start from where the underneath of your underarm until you reach the back part. But you don't have to make it really fit. You have to give some big space because this double crochet stitch will stretching and we keep for making the back tie or back corset. And next, we are going to make the bust part. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 1, chain 6. Then turn your work, skip 3 chains, and make double crochet into the 4th chain. Keep making double crochet into each chain until you reach the double crochet stitch. And after you reach the double crochet stitch, then continue make the double crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the first row of the bust part looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 3, turn your work, skip one stitch, then new chain 3, and make the double crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then I will meet you back again. And after you have 2 last stitches, then we are going to make decrease by make the double crochet 2 together. To make the double crochet 2 together, yarn over, insert the hook into the back loop of the stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, push through 2 loops, and now you have 2 loops on your hook, then yarn over and continue insert the hook into the next back loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and now you must have 2 stitches with 3 loops on the hook. Then yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, for row 3, chain 3. For chain 3, we don't count as a stitch. Turn your work, skip 1 stitch, then new chain 3, and make the double crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. For this chain 3, we don't count as a stitch, and you can use stitch marker to mark at this first double crochet stitch. It is easy to know where your last stitch is. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And for the next row, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 13. Then we meet you back again. And for you guys that make bigger size, please keep decreasing until you reach the middle part of your chest. For this front bust, you have to measure it from the underarm until you reach the middle part of your chest. And then we are going to increase to make another half size of the bust part. And after you keep decrease until you reach the middle part of your chest. And next, for row 14, chain 3. Turn your work, skip and stitch the new chain 3. And make the bokeh shape back loop only into every stitch until you have one last stitch, then I will meet you back again. And after you have one last stitch, then we are going to make increase by make 2 the bokeh shape into the same loop. And after you have made 2 double crochet in the same loop, next, for row 15, chain 3. For chain 3, we also count as a stitch. Then turn your work and make the double crochet into the stitch that near chain 3. And now you must have 2 stitches, include the chain 3 stitch in the same loop. Keep making the bokeh shape back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. For the next row, please keep repeating row 14 and row 15 until you reach row 25. Then I will meet you back again. As you can see for my first side, which is the decreasing part, I have 13 rows. And for the other side, which is increasing part, you have to make 13 rows the same. But for the last row, you just make normal double crochet back loop only, no increase. It's like decreasing part, which is for the first row, we don't make decrease. And for my front bust part, in total, I have 26 rows. As you can see, for the last row, I don't make increase. Just place a double crochet into the last stitch. And you can count the number of the stitches of this last row to make sure you have the same number of the stitches like the other side. And after you got your bust part, and next, we are going to continue make the back part of the top. And if your row end down here, you can chain 3, turn your work, and make the double crochet back loop only until you have 4 last stitches. It's like the other side that we made for the double crochet stitches. So for the second side, you have to skip 4 stitches. And if your row end up here like mine, you just continue from where your last stitch is. For row 1, turn your work and make slip stitch back loop only. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and push through all the loops. Keep making slip stitch back loop only into the next 4 stitches. In total, you must have 5 slip stitch. And after you reach the 5th stitch, then chain 3. For chain 3, we also count as a stitch. As you can see, we have skipped 4 stitches like the other side. And next, continue make the double crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Next, for row 2 until row 13, chain 3, turn your work, and make the double crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 13. You must have the same number of the row like the other side. And now we are done for the bust part. Next, continue from where your last stitch is. And we are going to make single crochet around the top as the border. To begin, chain 1 and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. And next, we are going to make the bottom part of the top. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is for row 1, chain 3. For chain 3, we also count as a stitch. Then continue make the double crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Next, for row 2 until row 6, chain 3, turn your work, skip one stitch then near chain 3, then make double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. So start from row 2, you just make double crochet into both loops. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 6. If you guys want your top more longer, please add more rows. And next, fold your top into 2 pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part of the top. Then measuring this corner part, which is the underarm, down until the under bust and use stitch marker to mark it. You can count the number between this both stitch marker. I have 24 stitches and mark at the 25th stitch. And then you have to count the same number to the other side. Start from the middle stitch marker by count 24 stitches and mark at the 25th stitch. It is to make sure that both sides are even. And this is what it looks like. And next, we are going to make the crease to make the V part of the corset top. As you can see, this is the right side of the stitch, so turn your work. We are going to working on the wrong side of the stitch. To begin, attach the yarn into the first stitch marker. Then chain 3. And then make the crease into the next stitch by making the double crochet 2 together. After you have made the crease, don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this decreasing stitch. And next, continue make double crochet into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches from the 3rd stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. And after you have 3 last stitches, then we are going to make the crease by making double crochet 3 together. And after you have made the crease, next for row 2, chain 3, turn your work, skip one stitch then near chain 3 and make the crease into the next stitch by making the double crochet 2 together. After you have made the double crochet 2 together, don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this double crochet stitch. And then continue make the double crochet into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. And after you have 3 last stitches, then we are going to make the crease by making the double crochet 3 together. And after you have made the crease, And for the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 8, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 8. For the length of this row 8, it is equal 4.5 inches length. And for you guys that make bigger size, you can keep decreasing until you got your desired fit. And next, we are going to make single crochet around this bottom edge to begin turn your work and attach the yarn into the corner stitch. Then chain 1 and make single crochet into every stitch around the V part until you reach the other corner stitch. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the other corner. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And next, we are going to make the ribbon of the corset top. First, you have to use stitch marker to mark at the underarm part, the nipple part, and you also mark the same thing for the other side, the underarm part, the nipple part, and the middle part. For making the line of the corset top, it starts with the slip stitch on the surface and then make the single crochet row. We have 3 different lines. For the first line, it's tilted than the second line. So you have to make slip stitch into every loop and working the stitch like the italics line. And for the second line, it's not really tilt. So you have to working 2 slip stitch and skip 1 stitch. For the red color, it's mean where you have to skip the stitch. And for the third line, it's a straight line. So you only make slip stitch into each loop or each space of the double crochet stitch. And next, I'm gonna show you how to make slip stitch on surface of your crochet work. To begin, I recommend you to use bigger hook. For me, I use 3.5 mm hook. And next, we start working from where we use stitch marker to mark. You have to hold the yarn under the top and insert the hook from above. And pull the yarn from the underneath. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop. And pull the yarn up. Then skip this line and continue insert the hook into the next loop. Then repeat the same thing into this line and into the next loop. You have to make two slip stitch and then skip one line or one loop. This is the method for the second line. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row. And make sure you have two working like the italics line. And after you reach the end of the row, then chain one, turn your work, and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. And after you reach the end of the row, then leave a long tail of yarn and cut it off. For the remaining yarn, weave in into the wrong side of the top. And next, I'm going to show you how to make in the straight line. Attach the yarn from where the stitch marker is. And make slip stitch into the big loop, which is the space between the double crochet stitch. For this straight line, you have to make slip stitch a little bit loose, so you have to pull the yarn a little bit longer or loose, then make slip stitch until you reach the end of the row. And after you reach the end of the row, then chain one and make single crochet into the next two stitches. It is the small loop. And for the big loop, we are going to make increase by make two single crochet into the same loop. And then for the next loop, you just make one single crochet. And for the next stitch, you just repeat by make one stitch with increase and one stitch with a single crochet. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And for the next line, you just repeat like the second line and the first line. And after you got 5 rib bone lines, and next we are going to make the straight line between the bust part and the bottom part of the top. To begin, we are start working from the right side and attach the yarn into the front loop. Then chain 1 and keep making single crochet into every loop until you reach the rib bone row, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the rib bone row, you have to make single crochet the rib bone row with the front loop by insert the hook into this rib bone stitch or the single crochet stitch. Then continue insert the hook into the front loop, yarn over, push through both loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then yarn over, push through 2 loops, and you just repeat the same thing when you reach the rib bone line, and continue make single crochet into every loop until the end of the row. And after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. And next, we are going to make the strap. To begin, I'm start working from the left strap. Attach the yarn into the corner stitch. For row 1, chain 3. For chain 3, we also count as a stitch. Then make double crochet into the same loop with chain 3. And then make double crochet into the next stitch. And after you have made a double crochet, then make increase into the next stitch by make 2 double crochet into the same loop. And after you got 2 double crochet in the same loop, and now you must have 5 stitches in total. Next, for row 2, chain 4. For chain 4, we also count as a stitch. Turn your work. Skip 2 stitches and make a double crochet into the 3rd stitch. Then chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make a double crochet into the chain 3 stitch. And this is what the second row looks like. And next, for row 3, chain 3. For chain 3, we also count as a stitch. Turn your work, then make a double crochet into the loop near chain 3. And continue make a double crochet into the chain space. Keep making the double crochet into each stitch and each chain space until you reach the last stitch, which is the chain stitch. Then we meet you back again. And after you reach the chain stitch, we are going to increase into the chain stitch by make 2 double crochet into the same loop. This is what it looks like. You must have the increasing stitch at the front of the row and at the end of the row. And next, we are going to make the mesh stitch. For row 4, chain 4. Turn your work, skip 2 stitches, and make the double crochet. And then chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and make the double crochet into the next stitch. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And for the next row, please keep repeating row 3 and row 4 until you reach row 12. then I will meet you back again. If you want your strap more longer, you can keep increasing by repeat row 3 and row 4. For this strap, we're measuring from the underarm until the top of the shoulder. And after you reach row 12, for the measurement of these 12 rows, it is equal 6 inches length. And next, we are going to make the crease. Continue from where your last stitch is for row 13, chain 3. Turn your work. Skip one stitch that near chain 3. And make a double crochet into each chain space and each stitch until you reach chain 4 stitch, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach chain 4 stitch, then we are going to make the crease but make a double crochet 2 together. After you have made the crease, next, for row 14, chain 4, turn your work, skip 2 stitches and make the double crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make the double crochet into the next stitch. Please keep repeating this until you have 3 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. And after you have 3 last stitches, then chain 1, skip 2 stitches and make the double crochet into the last stitch, which is the chain 3 stitch. And for the next row, please keep repeating row 13 and row 14 until you reach row 23, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 23. For this last row, you must have the same number of the stitches like the first row that we start. I have 5 stitches, and as you can see, for the first row, we have 5 stitches the same. And then we are going to connect this strap into the back part of the top. To begin, turn the strap wrong side out. And make slip stitch both sides together. Then make single crochet both sides together into each stitch until the end of the row. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the right side of the stitch looks like. And now we are done for the left strap. And next, for the right strap, you just count 2 stitches from the corner and attach the yarn into the 3rd stitch, then repeat the same thing like the left strap. And after you're done for both straps, and next, we are going to make single crochet at the top part. To begin, attach the yarn into the front loop of the stitch. then chain 1 and make single crochet into every front loop until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And for the last stitch, you just make slip stitch. Then cut off the yarn. And next, we are going to make the shell stitch. To begin, attach the yarn into the back loop. Then chain 1. Skip 2 stitches and make 5 double crochet into the third stitch. After you got 5 double crochet in the same loop, then skip 2 stitches and make slip stitch into the 3rd stitch. And after you have made slip stitch, then skip 2 stitches and make 5 double crochet into the 3rd stitch. And after you have made 5 double crochet, skip 2 stitches and make slip stitch into the 3rd stitch. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please weave in into the wrong side of the stitch. And next, we are going to make the string for the bow tie at the strap by make 60 chains for both strings. And now the very core setup is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Subscribe to my channel and don't forget to follow me on my social medias. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.